What's good guys, this is Azeem Ali and I am back with another video. I hope you are all having an amazing day, and in today's video we are going to talk about whether push-pull legs versus single muscle versus full body, which is better. So let's get on. With that being said guys, let's get on to the first point. That is going to be, we are going to talk about the pros and cons of push-pull legs. So first things first guys, with push-pull legs you get an increased frequency in training. What that means is you get to train twice a week as opposed to once a week. Now the volume might decrease a bit because you can't go as intense on every muscle, but still you get increased frequency. That means you get multiple growth periods with it as well. Now the next added benefit that you get from push-pull legs is going to be your training does not overlap. What I mean by that is your push workout does not have to overlap with your pull workout, and your pull workout does not have to overlap with your legs, which means you get to hit the push muscles, that is going to be your chest, shoulder and triceps, much more efficiently because you get to hit them separately on a single day, and the same with other muscles as well and on other days as well. So one of the things once again that is more beneficial with push-pull legs guys is that you get to train more efficiently. What I mean by that is if you are someone who is living a very busy lifestyle and he does not have the time to train 6 days a week, then what he can do is he can apply the push-pull legs training in the 3 days. So you can do your push on Monday, your pull on Wednesday and legs on Friday. That way you actually get recovery in between them as well, and you can go much higher in intensity and volume as well and frequency as well. Plus it's much more time saving as opposed to if you are doing single muscle, then you have to go to the gym 6 days a week at least, which is not very viable. So what I would like to say is all of these points that I've given you guys here are the pros of push-pull legs. Now let's talk about the pros of bro split. Now talking about bro split guys, one of the added benefits that you get with bro split is you get to train one muscle at a time, which means you get to focus on one muscle at a time much more, because now you don't have to worry about training your chest or shoulder or triceps at once. Whereas with push-pull legs, you have to be more focused on training several body parts in a day, because of which you don't get to focus on that single muscle much more efficiently. With single muscle, you have this added benefit to it as well. Now, the next thing that is very beneficial with single muscle is that you get to focus on your lagging body parts much better. So maybe if your chest is weak or your shoulder is weak, you actually get to give it a whole day in which you can hit it with much more volume, with much more intensity. That is going to help you grow your muscle much better. Now once again, what happens if you are training with push-pull legs is you don't get to hit your lagging body parts much more efficiently, because you have to focus on training all three muscles at the same time. That is going to be your chest, shoulder, triceps. With single muscle, you don't have that much of a problem in this aspect especially. Now, the other added benefit to single muscle is that you get to go at much more volume and much more higher intensity. Once again, because you are focusing solely on one muscle, you get to go much higher in the intensity. You get to go much higher in the volume and you actually get to kill the muscle. So that is a beneficial part of single muscle. Now let's talk about full body, and this is going to be our last point. Now let's talk about full body guys. Once again, with full body what happens here is you get to train twice a week and just in a 4 day span. How wonderful is that? Once again, this is happening because you are actually training in an upper-lower split. What I mean by that upper-lower split is that in those 4 days that I have given you, you get to train your whole upper body on Monday, then you can train your lower body on Tuesday. On Monday, you can go with your chest, shoulder, triceps, biceps, back, so on and so forth. And on Tuesday, you can go with your legs, abs, calves, and muscles like that. and then you can repeat this on the next 2 days of your split as well. So what is happening here is, once again, you are getting those multiple growth periods that you wanted. Plus, it's much more time saving and it's much more efficient as well for building muscle. Because for someone who is very busy out there, who lives a very busy lifestyle out there and wants to train each muscle twice a week because he wants to enhance his muscle growing potential, then this is definitely going to work for you, because you don't have to hit the gym 6 days a week, which means it's much more time saving, it's much more energy saving, and you don't have to invest all of your time in the gym and be obsessed with the gym. Now guys, one thing that you guys need to keep in mind here is all of the pointers that I've given you with all of these three splits. That is going to be your push-pull legs, your full body, and your single muscles have their pros and cons in and of itself. Personally, I would recommend you guys that you go for push-pull legs, but that is my personal recommendation and you have to follow which one's the best for you. Like, I have laid out all of these three splits right here in front of you guys, and you have to choose what works best for you. Once again, I'm stating this. Now, with that being said, guys, I'm going to end my today's video right here. If you actually enjoyed this video, show some love by liking this video. Comment down in the comment section below if you have any further queries or if you have any further video recommendations. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel and also press on that notification bell as well. Until next time, have an amazing day, guys. See you.